Online shopping and banking are terribly convenient, aren't they? With just a few clicks, you can buy anything from groceries to gadgets and manage your finances without stepping out of your home. No more queuing or schlepping around shops. You can avoid the crowds, the traffic, and the hassle of finding a parking spot. But listen up, darlings, because there are risks. The digital world, while convenient, is also a playground for cybercriminals. Just like you wouldn't leave your handbag open on Oxford Street, you can't be careless online. Leaving your personal information unprotected is like inviting trouble. Think of hackers as those pesky pickpockets, always lurking in the shadows. They're constantly on the lookout for any opportunity to steal your information. They're after one thing, your hard-earned money. And they can be very sneaky about it, using phishing scams, malware, and other tricks to get what they want. But don't worry, sweetie, with a little bit of caution, you can outsmart them. It's all about being aware and taking the right precautions. Think of it like this, darling. Your online safety is like a good pair of knickers. Absolutely essential. Just as you wouldn't leave the house without them, you shouldn't go online without proper protection. We're going to talk about some simple steps to keep your online shopping and banking as safe as Fort Knox. From using strong passwords to enabling two-factor authentication, there are many ways to protect yourself. Because, darling, in this digital age, you've got to be savvy. Stay informed, stay cautious, and you'll be able to enjoy the convenience of the digital world without falling victim to its dangers. Now, passwords are your first line of defense, darling. Don't be using password 123 or, God forbid, your pet's name. That's just asking for trouble. A strong password is like a good stiff drink. It needs to be complex. Think uppercase and lowercase letters, numbers, and symbols all mixed up like a good cocktail. And don't even think about using the same password for everything. That's like using the same key for your house, your car, and your secret stash of chocolate biscuits. Recipe for disaster, darling. Use a different strong password for every single account. It's a bit of a bother, I know, but trust me, it's worth it. Now let's talk about two-factor authentication, or 2FA for those in the know. This nifty little feature is becoming more and more essential in our digital age. It's like having a burly bodyguard for your accounts. Imagine a towering figure standing guard, making sure no one gets in without proper clearance. Even if some dodgy geezer gets hold of your password, they still can't get in without that second layer of security. This second layer is what makes 2FA so powerful and effective. Usually it's a code sent to your phone or email. This code is unique and changes every time you log in, making it nearly impossible for hackers to predict or reuse. It might seem like a bit of a faff, but believe me, it's a small price to pay for peace of mind. Knowing that your personal information and accounts are secure can save you from a lot of stress and potential financial loss. Think of it like this. It's like having to wear shoulder pads in the 80s. A bit much? Maybe. Effective? Absolutely. Just like those shoulder pads, 2FA adds an extra layer of protection that might seem cumbersome, but is ultimately worth it. So turn on 2FA whenever you can, darling. It's a simple step that can make a world of difference in keeping your digital life secure. It's like adding an extra shot of vodka to your martini. It packs a punch. And just like that extra shot, 2FA gives your security an extra kick, making it much harder for those nasty hackers to get through. Whether it's your email, social media, or banking apps, enabling 2FA is a smart move. It's a small step that can prevent big problems down the line. So go ahead, take that extra step. Your future self will thank you for it. Stay safe, stay secure, and keep those hackers at bay. Now, when you're shopping or banking online, you need to make sure you're on a secure website. How do you know? Look for the https://, at the beginning of the web address. That S is crucial, sweetie. It stands for secure. It's like the bouncer at a posh club, making sure everything is above board. And keep an eye out for the little padlock symbol in the address bar. That's another sign you're in safe hands. If a website looks dodgy or suspicious, trust your instincts, darling. There are plenty more fish in the sea, or in this case, websites on the internet. Section 5. Public Wi-Fi. A public toilet for your finances? Absolutely not. Public Wi-Fi is awfully tempting, isn't it? Especially when you're desperate for a quick online shopping spree. But darling, using public Wi-Fi for banking or shopping is like sharing your toothbrush with a stranger. Absolutely ghastly. You never know who's watching or what they might be up to. Those hackers are clever little devils. They could be lurking on that free Wi-Fi like wasps around a picnic. If you absolutely must use public Wi-Fi, at least have the decency to use a VPN. It's like putting on a disguise, darling, making it much harder for those pesky hackers to see what you're up to. Section 6. Watch your accounts like a hawk or patsy after a bottle of Stoli. Now, even if you're careful, it's always best to be vigilant. Keep an eye on your bank and credit card statements like a hawk, darling. Look for any suspicious transactions, no matter how small. And if you see something fishy, report it immediately. It's better to be safe than sorry, as they say. Most banks and credit card companies have apps these days, which are terribly useful for keeping track of your spending. It's like having your own personal accountant, but without the hefty fees. Set up alerts so you get notified of any unusual activity. That way, you can catch any fraudulent charges quicker than you can say, sweetie darling. Another great tip is to enable two-factor authentication on your accounts. This adds an extra layer of security, making it harder for fraudsters to access your information. Regularly updating your passwords is also crucial. Use a mix of letters, numbers, and special characters to create strong, unique passwords. Consider using a password manager to keep track of all your passwords securely. And don't forget to monitor your email for any suspicious activity or phishing attempts. If something looks off, don't click on any links or download attachments. Taking these steps can give you peace of mind, knowing your accounts are secure. So stay alert, stay safe, and keep those accounts in check, darling. After all, a little vigilance goes a long way in protecting your hard-earned money. Section 7. Secure payment methods. Keep your money safe and sound. When it comes to paying online, stick to secure payment methods like your credit card or reputable services like PayPal. They offer an extra layer of protection if something goes wrong. And never, ever send cash in the post or transfer money directly to someone you don't know. That's like handing them your handbag and wishing them luck. Remember, darling, when it comes to online payments, it's always better to be safe than sorry. Section 8, phishing scams. Don't be fooled by these dodgy emails, sweetie. Now let's talk about phishing scams. These are emails or messages designed to trick you into giving away your personal information. They might look official, but don't be fooled, darling. They're as dodgy as a fake Chanel handbag. Never click on links in emails or messages you weren't expecting. And if you're ever unsure, go directly to the company's website or give them a call. Remember, darling, if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. And if you ever get an email from a Nigerian prince promising you millions, just hit delete. Section 9, software updates. A bit of digital Botox keeps everything running smoothly? I know, software updates can be a bit of a bore, but trust me, darling, they're important. They're like a good facial for your computer, keeping everything running smoothly and, most importantly, securely. Those updates often include security patches that fix vulnerabilities hackers could exploit. So next time you see that little update notification, don't ignore it. Just click update and be done with it. Section 10. Antivirus software. Your digital bouncer, keeping the bad guys out. Antivirus software is like having a burly bouncer for your computer, darling. It keeps out all the nasty viruses and malware that can steal your information or wreak havoc on your system. Make sure you have a good antivirus program installed and keep it updated. It's a small price to pay for peace of mind. Section 11. Logging out. Always leave the party early, especially when money's involved. And finally, darling, always remember to log out of your accounts when you're finished, especially on public computers or shared devices. It's like closing your handbag after you've taken something out. You wouldn't just leave it gaping open for anyone to rifle through, would you? Section 12. Stay safe, spend wisely, and keep your account details under wraps. So there you have it, sweetie darling. A few simple tips to keep you safe and sound in the wild world of online shopping and banking. Remember, a little bit of caution goes a long way. Stay safe, spend wisely, and keep those account details under wraps. And remember, if in doubt, just call me darling. I might not be a computer whiz, but I know how to spot a dodgy deal a mile off.